job's a joke you broke. Your love lasts to your way. It's like you're always...
Ugh! That was a good game.
Yeah,
I'm parched.
Wait, what's that?
Let me see.
It appears to be some kind of scroll.
Huh?
A ray diagram is a diagram that traces the path that light takes in order for a person to view a point on the image of an object. A ray diagram can either show a real image, or when light rays pass through and diverge from the image point shown by solid lines, or a virtual image, when light rays do not pass through the image point, but only appear to diverge from that point, shown by dotted lines. A ray diagram can be made from several variables. P is the object location, Q is the image location, H is the object height, H prime is the image height, F is focal length, and M is magnification. These variables can be related through several equations. The first is the inverse of object location plus the inverse of image location is equal to the inverse of the focal length. Second is magnification is equal to the image height over the object height is equal to the negative image location over the object location. These equations can be applied to two different main types of diagrams: lenses, which can be convergent or divergent, or mirrors, which can be convex or concave.
There's an evil man named Dr. Diopter.
Dr. Diopter was once a respected scholar. He had a PhD in science and was totally popular. His vision began to fail, however, and it turned him into a meanie. He became such a meanie about his lack of vision that he made up a plan to take everyone in the world's vision, even his own mother's.
Why don't you just get glasses, honey?
They make me look ridiculous!
It says use this knowledge to defeat Dr. Diopter.
But how do we do that?
Guys!
There's something else in here. They're magical contact lenses.
Well, what are they used for?
I'll put it on.
It's a map.
Whoa!
But how did that work?
The contact lenses act as a converging lens. To make a lens diagram, you first draw the lens vertically and an axis horizontally. From there, draw a focal point on each side of the lens, and for the sake of this example, draw a distance 2 focal lengths away on either side. Next, take the object's distance and height and draw it on the axis like so. Let's just say the map is 10 feet away and 6 feet in the air. From there, we will draw a ray of light traveling from the map horizontally into the lens and then angle down into the opposite focal point. For this example, we will say the focal points are 5 feet from the lens. Next, draw another ray of light traveling from the object into the base of the lens and continue on at that angle until you intersect the other light ray. For the last ray of light, draw it from the object into the first focal point and then angled parallel to the horizontal axis. Where these points meet is the image. Using the equation 1 over P plus 1 over Q equals 1 over F, we can input our known values and solve for Q, or the image distance. From this, we know that in this case, the image appears 10 feet from the lens. Using different cases for the focal point and object distance, we can make the object appear further or closer. From the diagram, we can see the image appears in front of the object, so it is real, and we can also see it appears on the bottom side of the horizontal axis, which shows it's inverted. And that is how lenses work.
What's with the glasses?
Well, you see, they're convex mirrors. They reflect light.
Come on. Dr. Diopter's this way. Oh, careful crossing this bridge. There's alligators in that boat.
Alligators? No!
Oh! Oh, hey! Alright. Let's keep moving.
Man, we really gotta get to his lair now.
Yeah, we gotta vent Dre and stuff.
Not so fast. To cross this bridge, you must answer a riddle.
An object is placed 20 centimeters from a converging lens that has a focal length of 10 centimeters. Make a ray diagram of the situation. From the ray diagram, characterize the image. To start, we'll draw a ray of light horizontally from the object into the lens, and then angle down through the focal point on the opposite side of the lens. Next, we draw a line diagonally from the object to the base of the lens and continue through. Lastly, draw a ray from the object through the focal point and then horizontally, intersecting the other two light rays. This image is real and inverted based on the positioning of the diagram.
But wait, I can make your fingers shoot lasers if you answer me another riddle.
An object is placed 20 centimeters from a concave mirror that has a focal length of 30 centimeters. Make a ray diagram of this situation. From the ray diagram, characterize the image. For a mirror, we will start by drawing a light ray traveling from the object horizontally into the mirror and reflected down into the focal point. Next, we draw a ray from the focal point through the object and continuing on to the mirror, then reflecting horizontally off of it. Keep in mind that the part of the ray between the focal point and the object is virtual, so we dot the line. Lastly, we draw a ray angled down into the base of the mirror and then reflected off of it at the same angle. Continue these lines through where they are drawn with dotted lines, and the intersection is the perceived image. This object is virtual and upright based on its position.
Thanks, troll.
Dr. Diopter.
When? It seems that you've made it further than I've expected.
This one's for Ray.
Yeah, so shut your big stupid bass hole.
Pew. 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 Pew.
Agents, now look out! My arm!
Wait.
The glasses! Agent Snell!
In this situation, Captain Diffraction's glasses serve as a convex mirror. The mirror is 4 meters away from Dr. Diopter's position. We'll say the focus is 2 meters away from the mirror, and the center point is 1 meter away from that distance. First, we draw a line parallel to the axis, starting at the height of the object and hitting the mirror. Once the line hits the mirror, it reflects to the focus. On the real side of the mirror, the light is reflected off of a continuation of that line. Next, we draw a line from the height of the object to the mirror again. This time, the line is directed toward the center point, and the light on the real side is directed right back along the same path. The lines on the virtual side of the mirror intersect. Finally, we draw a third line again from the top of the object to the mirror. This time, the line is directed toward the focus. We draw a line parallel to the axis from the point where that line crosses the lens. On the real side, the light is reflected along the path. The point where all three of these lines on the imaginary side is the top of the virtual image. The rest of the image extends to the axis. In this case, the image is virtual and upright. Now we can use this equation to solve for where that image will be positioned. In this equation, P represents the distance from the object to the mirror, F represents the distance from the focus to the mirror, and Q represents the distance from the image to the mirror. By plugging these values into the equation, we can solve for the image distance to be 2 meters. Now that I have a better understanding of these mirrors, I can use these calculations to my advantage.